Okay, so fire safety and prevention is the next topic which we will be discussing today. Okay, so first of all, fire safety. So one of the basic safety prevention system which has to be installed in a building, in an institution, in a commercial installation, could be a could be some a type of a commercial establishment like some shopping mall or office or some manufacturing structure like the factories, the manufacturing area. Everywhere we have to take the precautions of fire safety. Okay, any type of risk, not even little bit of risk we can take there. Another thing is that spread of the fire broke out and then it spreads very widely. That prevention is the best solution how to overcome this situation. Okay, so some of the causes which I am going to cover here today. Okay, especially in the residential area. Okay, many of the factors could be due to human errors. Some could be due to some technical faults. So we will discuss both due to human errors as well as due to some technical faults. Okay, we can, yeah, and one more thing is that why we need a protection system and highly advanced fire protection system. First of all, the basic thing is that we cannot solely rely on the human efforts. There could be some mistakes by human due to some human activity. There could be a fire. So we prefer an automated system. Okay, like in the buildings, on every floor at some distance, the fire extinguishers, they are placed. That is one of the preventive measure which is being taken to prevent the fire, to minimize the risk. Okay, one more common thing I will cover, that is the centralized air conditioning system. It is centralized, so it can also enhance the spread of fire. So comfort is there, but safety is also needed. So that makes the fire protection system to be more advanced. Okay, so now considering some of the common but important causes of fire. So cooking. So very common factor, especially in the residential area. Okay, first of all, the type of building under consideration, that is also an important factor. Okay, like in the commercial building, like in the shopping mall or in a factory, in some corporate sector buildings, cooking is not one of the main reason for fire. Okay, cooking is basically much more related to the residential area, the building, residential building, like the housing societies. Okay, also one more thing, that the commercial areas like the factories and the shopping malls or the corporate offices in the buildings, there we can put restrictions on these on the smoking. We can put restrictions anyone, because the employees there, the customers, those who are entering the area, we can put restrictions that no smoking here. Just a minute, let me put this another speaker away from here. Okay, now, yeah, so we can put restrictions. Okay, like on the buildings, we have seen in the corporate offices, smoking inside the building, that is totally restricted. Total prohibition inside, smoking inside there, inside the building. No one, anyone who wants to smoke, he has to leave. He has to leave the building, go outside. There he can smoke. Hotels also. Well, hotels is some type of related to residential buildings as well. So some smoking zones, they are isolated. So those who want to smoke, they can go to that zone there, a smoking zone. Otherwise, the other area, people are not allowed to smoke. Okay, but the factor of cooking, smoking, we will come back to that topic. Cooking, that is much more related to hotels, residential areas, and the food courts. In the commercial buildings, the eateries, okay, like the food chains, in the shopping malls, they are also there. Fast food joint points are there, eatering outlets are there. Very, some of them are very famous, big eatering chains, food chains. They have opened their outlet in shopping malls. Okay, canteens, food court area in the corporate buildings, they are also being provided. So there, one of the factor comes up. Okay, that cause of fire due to cooking. Next thing is open flame. So here a candle. Candle could be a source of open flame. So first of all, not much common in households, not much common in corporate sectors, but still it is finding some use in the candlelight dinners in the restaurants. Different restaurants are there. There you can, architect, interior designers, they give provision for candlelight dinners. And it is in good practice in the present day also. So there is a risk for open flame. Okay, otherwise these candles and all these open flame, they are not much common for in other buildings. Then heating, basically it is related with chimneys. Currently we are avoiding it. Centralized air conditioning and heating, ventilation and air conditioning centralized in a building, that is being that is a new approach. So old chimneys, they won't find a big application in the modern buildings. But the centralized heating, ventilation, air conditioning system, all this system build up in the buildings, they can also spread the fire. But they're centrally, they are connected from one point to another. So well, that we can deal with that by providing a very efficient firefighting system. Then incendiary or arson. Okay, this is the practical case, and this is out of the control of an architect, out of the control of a resident, of a worker there in the commercial space, commercial building. We can control it. Some type of protest is going on and people are there on the street. A mob is there and they are putting this property on fire. We have seen there many violent protests broke out. In the present scenario, many protests are going on. So any time the protest may go violent, and then the angry mob, they start putting the property, buildings, and vehicles on fire. So that is another one such type of case. We have to make provision for that. So this factor we cannot control. An architect cannot control, the builder cannot control, the residents of the building, they cannot control. Okay, although the we can consider that the our police force, they can control it. They can put some they can take some action for the angry mob so that they cannot demolish the properties, public property or the private property. Okay, but still anyway, we need a proper firefighting system. Then smoking. Yes, we were just discussing about the smoking. So we can see that one more reason why we should not demote, discourage smoking. It's of the fire causes. Except from health point of view, yes, smoking is from nowhere. It is a good from the health point of view. From the environment point of view, pollution, yes, that is also a major cause. Otherwise, one more thing is that it is creating a big discomfort, displeasure for the other people, nearby people, for their health as well. From the health point of view, okay, they will be affected by the person who is smoking in nearby. Okay, one more thing is that the smoking is also a cause of fire. We will discuss it in some detail. Okay, then electric fault. This could also be one source of fire. So, first of all, so there are all of the points we are discussing here. They are the leading causes of fire. So personal vigilance is the best way to avoid and survive fires. Then yes, personally we can avoid. Like the prevention. The prevention point of view, we can protect. We can prevent this fire, this type of situations. Okay, now cooking. Generally, while taking all the precautions, cooking will not harm. Okay, chimneys are provided there, smoke which is coming up, that is also leaving from the chimney to the exhaust system. That is working. Okay, but there could be some cases, only some cases, that our cooking, that can cause fire. So first of all, what are the precautions we shall take? So always pay attention to what you are cooking. Here are some factors like the moisture content. That is one of the factor. The food which we are cooking, that is having a high moisture content, then the risk of inflammation. Okay, the risk of high flames, that will be reduced. Okay, another thing, if you leave the room, turn off the stove. Basically, what it means that always keep an eye on the cooking stove. So whenever you think, whenever there is some type of situation like a fire started working out, then switch off the stove. Okay, another thing, don't cook if you are sleepy or if you are impaired. In that case, something undesirable happens. Then the person won't be able to sense it or take some preventive actions. Okay, so how we can reduce this cooking? The fire, the chances of fire due to cooking. Yes, some of the common practices are the clothing. The cloth and towel, these things usually people use in different sections, not only in household. In the kitchens, there in the some food outlets as well. So the clothes, they are inflammable. There, if it is nearby, people are using these clothes to grab the hot utensils. So there is a chance that the fire could be there in the cloth. Our cloth can catch fire and the fire will spread. So always keep inflammable items away from heat sources. Okay, one more thing which leads to this fire and is one of the preventive measure is the leakage of the gas, cooking gas. Many times the government itself, some social services agencies, they are also trying to increase the awareness that whenever there is a situation that the cooking gas that is leaking, then always pay attention to that. Don't light up a matchstick, a smoking, or don't even switch on the light when there's a leakage of gas. Just open the windows so that that gas can leak out. Could go out from the house itself. So these are some type of the inflammable items. The LPG cylinder itself is also an inflammable item. Okay, one more factor thing which we will consider here is the grease. So always clean your stovetop frequently to avoid grease buildup. Another thing, keep flammable cleaners away from heat sources. In the present scenario, the the sanitizers which we are using, they are also alcohol based. The alcohol that is also inflammable. So sanitizers, try to avoid all of these type of sanitizers near the flames, like the cooking fire. Okay, so cleaners, they could also be inflammable. So our practice should be to isolate this type of inflammable items from the cooking fire, especially more especially in our kitchen. Okay, so grease fire. Okay, so grease fires. So always there should be a matching lid nearby. Means we have to avoid the fire due to this grease. That is why we considered one of the point that always clean our stove so that the grease should not be there. Okay, so a small amount of fire like shown in the image, this could be a grease fire. So always matching lid is there, put the lid on. In case you think that a fire is going out, it is working out, is going out of control, then put the lid there. So matching lid, that is why we have to take with us. We keep nearby. And never put water on a grease fire. So try to use, well, we don't need this type of specification that what is needed here. Okay, so never put water on a grease fire. So one of the precautions which we have to take care. Next factor is smoking. So one more case is here, except from the buildings, the cigarette or the smoking, and then careless disposal of the cigarettes after smoking. So the cigarette butts we can consider. So their careless and improper disposal also is a big cause of fire in the building as well as some other areas. Like one of the factor could be the forest. Dry leaves, they are scattered everywhere on the ground. So if the staff there, someone is smoking, threw away that cigarette there on the dry leaves, they are flammable. So this could lead to a major disaster. So always we have to take care of the such type of factors. That small carelessness that could lead to a big disaster. Okay, now coming to the buildings. So one thing which I addressed here earlier, that was in a commercial establishment like an academic institution, buildings there, totally smoking is prohibited. No one can smoke here. So anyone who wants to smoke has to leave. Leave the building, go out. Similarly, other type of buildings are there, like the commercial installations, shopping malls. Okay, now corporate offices. There, smoking is totally prohibited. No one will smoke there, always leave out. But in case of residential areas, this thing can create a problem. Because in that case, we cannot very easily, we can put restrictions, make prohibitions. Because in that case, the residents, they are the owners. Okay, and they are the customers, like for the management, the residents, they are the customers. So inside the house, what they are doing, not very easy to control, not very easy to monitor. So here the human awareness is the only solution that create awareness among those residents in the residential society, housing societies. Okay, so one cigarette, it can smolder for hours. It is not like that a person who smoked and threw it away after he smoked and threw that cigarette, but there in the anywhere there on the floor or anywhere, it is smoldering. Because that is the one of the big cause of fire. Because the person, the smoking, he has neglected it, he has thrown it away, but still the cigarette is smoldering. So some tips here to avoid this type of fires which are caused due to smoking. First of all, our practice should be like, don't smoke inside. Okay, always try to, wherever anyone who wants to smoke, then he should go outside, not indoor, in outdoor. He should go outdoor. Okay, then discard the smoking materials because it is smoldering for hours. So always discard the smoking materials in a fire safe container. Okay, for that, proper heavy ashtray, and that should be totally not flammable. Okay, like a light plastic ashtray is placed there, then that is not that will not solve the purpose. Itself, it could cause fire. Okay, so smoking is a leading cause of fire deaths everywhere. So how can we avoid these things? Some more tips are here. Proper disposal is needed, outdoor smoking. Okay, then don't smoke in bed. These are the points which could create awareness among the people, among the inhabitants of a housing society, residents of the housing society. We can only create awareness. Then only we can avoid these type of situations. Otherwise, if a fire breaks out, then we should be having a proper firefighting system. Okay, the, like, don't smoke in the bed. Clothing is there, that is inflammable. Okay, another thing, don't smoke if you are tired. This is something related to human psychology. Okay, for some people, or for the smokers itself, the smoking, that gives a sense of relaxation. So if a person is tired, then he smokes, he will feel relaxed. But similarly, this relaxation will give rise to negligence. Proper disposal, that won't take place. Improper disposal, that could lead to fire. Then taking medications. This is from the health point of view as well. Even the doctors, they are also giving a strict warning that if you are on medication, then don't smoke, don't drink. Even in the vaccination of this corona, this precaution was given. If you are vaccinated, then don't smoke and drink for this much of time. So on medications also, it has to be avoided. Maybe a person is on medication and he smokes and something in his body, he just faints out. Then again, improper disposal of the cigarette or the anything for smoking, that will again lead to fire. Next thing, if a person is drinking or if a person is impaired, then he is not able to sense out that a fire is breaking out. Okay, another thing is like a party. One of a very common area for smoking. Party is there, gathering is there, people are there to enjoy, and all of them will smoke now. So always check after party is over, then always check that these cigarette butts which are disposed of, are they smoldering? Okay, or are they near to any furniture or cushions or any this clothing items there in the hall? If it is there, then try to remove it. Okay, now another thing is the candles. So unattended candles, okay, they lead to fire. How many students? 9. Okay.
8.
Okay, so candles. First of all, used for lighting, that purpose is not related to the current situation. In the present scenario, candles are basically used as a decorative purpose. Okay, like in the candlelight dinners or like in the photos, you can see these are decorative lightings. Mostly they are used in these situations for decoration. Restaurants could be using it for these candlelight dinners or for some decoration purpose. So interior designers, they are dealing with this thing. Okay, so use flameless candles. Okay, if it is like a decorative candle and it is being kept on a side table, and then okay, so if the candle that is placed on a side table and that side table or side stool or any such position and curtains are near, then there is a risk of a fire. So such type of negligence or the improper management, improper placing, that should be avoided. Okay, and after the party is over, okay, like in the restaurant, there is a dinner, candlelight dinner, dinner is over, then blow up the candles. Okay, so anything. Yes, ma'am. Okay, so anything inflammable that should be kept at a safe distance from the candles. Okay, one more thing is that we can use a cladding, like the glass covering for the candles, so as to avoid any type of contact with any type of a flammable object. And most common cases is the clothing. Curtains are mostly used for decoration. Very decorative type of curtains we are using. Okay, here basically, in the present scenario, only two type of situations are there in the case of a party, in a party hall. Candles could be there, and the same time curtains or decorative clothes, papers, they would also be there. Or other type of showpiece could be placed there near a candle, made up of wood or covered by some clothing or textile. So these things should be kept at a safe distance. Okay, at least 1 foot away. Another thing is the restaurants like that. The purpose is the same, the decoration purpose. Mostly lighting is not much based on candles in the present scenario. And many type of decorative lightings are also available which we are also discussing in our this subject. So the purpose of lighting is not solved by the not served by the candles in the present scenario. Okay, another thing is that don't set candles on anything combustible. Okay, the base where we have placed the candles, if it is a wooden table, or further we have put on some tablecloth, decorative tablecloth, it is looking nice, but a candle is above it. That is not a good practice. Anything flammable, that should not be in the base of the candle. So candle stands are there also. So best practice is always use such type of next thing is a electrical safety. Here what we are referring to is the well, let me leave it. Yes. Electrical safety means fire could also broke out due to faulty electric wiring, faulty loading as well. Okay, although in the present case, all of the safety equipments are provided in the electrical network. So any such type of situation can be avoided. Okay, first point here. Do not overload electrical sockets. Yes, this thing needs some consideration, and also it is related to your syllabus as well, that why overloading should be avoided. Okay, first of all, any type of device that is consuming some power. Okay, then the cables, the electric wires which are carrying the power, they always have their specific capacity, that how much power they can transfer. Okay, now here more specifically I am referring to a quantity, electric current, the current, how much current should be flown through a conductor, that should always be specific. Now overload, what happens that any type of device, any type of household appliance, any type of gadget that draws current, okay, against the load, means higher the load you are putting, then higher the current that machine is drawing. Let me take an example of any kitchen appliance. Okay, any mixer, juicer, any type of device is there, and we are putting some food stuff there inside the mixer. Then always it is safe if it is within the capacity. If you overload it, then the mixer, the motor of that mixer, then it will draw more current. Okay, so any type of machine, it is drawing the current against the load. So more overload means overcurrent. Overcurrent means overheating. This is what we call a Joule's law of heating. That the current, the heat developed by a conductor, that is proportional to the resistance, proportional to the time, proportional to the square of the current which is flowing through that conductor. Any type of medium which is there. So the amount of current increases, then in the term of square of the current, by that amount the heat increases, the more heat it will develop. So more load is increasing, that means the current that is increasing, and in the square, by square of by that almost double, so the square or term, in that term the heat is increasing. So overcurrent, overheating, and overload, overcurrent, overheating. So always everything should be operated in its specific power rating. How much load should be given to any type of device? That is always specified. Don't overload that. Okay, another thing, that heat that increases. So how, what it will do, it will burn the isolations. Okay, like our socket, yes, shown here in this figure. Okay, so the material that starts melting down due to heat, it is heating and it is melting. More heat, then it will burn. Okay, although the safety equipments are there, our MCB, which is placed, fused in MCBs, all of these things are placed for the protection purpose. Okay, but overloading is one such type of thing we shall always avoid. Okay, another thing, do not run cords or cables under these rugs or furniture, because itself that is also flammable. Wooden furniture is there. Now power cable is below it, right? Okay, so furniture that is in contact with a cable, now load is increased. The temperature of the conductor, the wire, the cable, that is increasing. That is hitting the wooden furniture. Now wood, that is also is an inflammable item. So it will get overheat. It will start burning. So this is how the fire that will propagate from one medium to another medium. Heat will transfer. When it will come in contact with some inflammable item, then that item will start burning, fire will spread. Okay, another thing, avoid putting cords against walls or across doorways. A proper wiring system is placed, that is why, to avoid these type of situations. Okay, so avoid power strips equipped with overload protection, like the extension cords are there. There we place a fuse. So whenever there is a condition of overheating, the fuse will break down. It will discontinue the supply, electric supply. So that such type of situation, overheating, burning, a fire, these situations can be avoided. Yes, and all of the type of extension cords, power cables, they should be tested and approved. So ISI mark is here in the India, it is given. So you can always use that. Now escape route. This is the core planning during the initial designing of a building. So from an architect's point of view, this is the one thing which has to be always kept in mind while designing a building. Okay, and also you would have seen there in the buildings, there is always a fire escape route. So whenever there is a fire, take this route. Usually it is the stairs. Okay, so how? First of all, the sensing system. Fire, smoke alarm. So how we build it? We use sensors. Place at some distance the different type of sensor and the alarm. They are placed at regular distance throughout the building. So smoke comes out, then the alarm will blow off now. Then that is a signal that yes, leave the building. Okay, there should be a meeting place where every resident or any occupant, whole of the gathering there in the building, they can meet at some place which is outside, out of the building. So whole of the gathering should be at that meeting place. So you have to plan, you have to take all of these consideration while making the layout of a building. But from where? The people, they can escape. So escape route should be there. Meeting place should be there. Okay, another thing, plan two ways. The escape route, two escape route. Okay, because it could be like that the fire broke out. Smoke is filled in one of the path. Then there should be another route as well. So this thing, the architect has to keep in mind while making the layout, the planning plan of a building. Now some of the safety items which should be placed there in the building. Okay, like one is the alarm, fire alarm. Another thing is fire extinguisher. So everywhere in the buildings, these things are placed. And then one more important thing is the fire sprinkler system. They are placed everywhere in the cabin, in each room, in the corridors. Everywhere the provision for this these systems is made. Even in the corridor of our institution, of our university, you can see that fire extinguishers are placed everywhere. Then alarms and smokes and this alarm and fire sprinkler systems, they are also placed. They are automated. The sensors are there. The controller is there. So as the fire breaks out, the smoke that is coming and the sensor that can sense it, it will raise an alarm. And at the same time, the fire water sprinkler system is there. That will be activated and it will start sprinkling the water there so as to minimize the risk of the spread of fire. Here, smoke alarm. Okay, this is some type of survey data which is here. Need not learn it by heart. Okay, breathing the smoke, that is another health issue related with it, because the smoke is toxic. It has an adverse effect on the health. Okay, if you must escape through smoke, get low and go under the smoke. Okay, try to avoid breathing in the smoke. Get low, like here shown in the this figure, in this image. So try to avoid it. Why? Just let me address it. This is one type of toxic gas, carbon monoxide. So this is emitted due to incomplete combustion. Okay, so fire broke out. Combustion, maybe it may not be proper. You might be thinking that how it could be that combustion is proper and improper combustion like that. It is basically like a wood, a solid wood is there and it is set on fire. Another thing is that wood that is broken down into very small pieces, very fine particles, then it is burned. So that is the difference. The small particles, they will burn completely. Okay, and the solid wood, that will not burn completely. So incomplete combustion, that emits many type of toxic gases. So one such type of gas is the carbon monoxide. Okay, so we cannot sense it. It is invisible, odorless, and colorless. So we cannot detect that carbon monoxide is there. But when a person breathes, inhales the carbon monoxide, then it combines with the hemoglobin in the blood. It forms a stable compound, carboxyhemoglobin. So basically it is a big hazard, inhaling of this carbon monoxide. So it can cause death within minutes. So that is the reason why we have to avoid inhaling of the smoke. Okay, and if a person who inhales the smoke, and then now he is not able to move, he is losing his senses. He cannot just run away as easily as a normal person is. Okay, so then further he needs help. That is why the firefighting team is always there. person could be trapped there. He's inhaled the smoke, then now he's losing his senses. Now he's not able to move and come out of the building. Okay, so here is some type of rough layout. That where we shall place the fire alarm. Okay, so it should be placed in almost every room, in the corridor, in the escape route. Like a sleeping room, living room, and then the stairs, corridors, we have placed this alarm. And they should be regularly checked. Okay, because of any failure, in a technical failure, that could be detected. So every month, it should be checked. Then batteries, every year they should be replaced. Okay, it should not be like that. The fire has broken. Fire broke out, and our alarm that is not operating. Then it will increase the damage. Residents won't be able to detect that a fire has broken out in the building. So regular maintenance should be there. In every room, at regular distance, the fire alarm should be placed. And there should be regular maintenance, regular checkup, regular quality check of this alarm, and basically of the whole firefighting system. Not only of the whole, not only the alarm, but the whole firefighting system, which we just discussed here. All of these equipments, firefighting equipment, they should be regularly checked. Okay, another thing, that the volume, they should be loud. Fire broke down at the night. People are sleeping. If the volume is low, it is not loud, then they won't realize that there's something unusual has gone there. Fire has broken out in the building. So it should be loud. So everyone, it should be audible to everyone, all of the residents in each room. Now coming to fire extinguishers here. So proper symbols are there. So how to use this fire extinguisher? This is a symbolic guide to the residents there of the building. So they should be knowing that how to use it. Okay, so whenever in the corridor, also in our university campus, you have seen that in the corridor the fire extinguishers are placed near the laboratories. The doors for entering or exiting the laboratories, there also fire extinguishers are placed. Okay, so they should be placed here. And they should also be checked regularly, so as to minimize the damage in case of any type of this mishap. Now one more thing, this is related to technology. Along with alarm, there is fire sprinkler system. So it is needed so as to reduce the damage to the property, damage to the life and the property. Now let me arrange it. Okay, so it should be automated. So automatically, like the smoke that can be detected, and after detecting the smoke, the alarms should be activated, and at the same time, fire sprinkler system that can be activated. Okay, so it is saving the life as well as the property. Minimize the damage due to fire. Now this is related to technology, that which sprinkler system should be activated. So which is nearest to the fire. Okay, now activating the sprinkler system for the whole building, that won't be advisable. So where there is a fire, at which floor, at which room, at which location. So the sprinkler system securing that area, that room, that location, that should be activated, and activated at once. Okay, so this is the safety measure to minimize the damage caused. And why it should be automated? Because manual supervision, then operation, although there should be a provision for manual operation as well, but they are automated, that automatically it will start working, the whole of the firefighting system. Okay, now what should every person, every common man, resident, inhabitant of the building, what should do? First of all, and in case of a fire, just leave the building. Okay, call this number for the ambulance. Then report it to the fire department. Just don't ignore the alarms. Fire alarms, as they started alarming, leave the building. Okay, yes, this is one thing, frequent alarms. That is related to psychological condition. That if frequently alarms are going on, then people start to neglect these alarms. But they should not be neglected, they should not be ignored. We have to pay attention every time the fire alarm is activated. So you try to escape from the building. Escape routes, the architects will already design during the layout, planning the layout of the building. Then just come out of the building. Okay, whenever you are out, just stay out. Don't try to enter again. Then call for the help for the fire department. Now here is summary of the things which we have just studied. How to reduce the risk of fire. So first of all, always stay focused. Whenever we are working on fire, so cooking, we are working on fire. So always be focused. We are using candles, then proper placing, distancing from inflammable items, vulnerable items, that should always be given. Yes, from the electrical point of view, don't avoid overloading. Overloading is the main cause of overheating, and overheating is the main cause of fire. Okay, and then improper placing of the cables, the cords, that should be avoided. Always there should be a proper placing, the proper space for the cables, for the cords. Okay, smoking. If anyone addicted to smoke, but precautions should be taken there. Not indoor, always make it outdoor, away from the inflammable items like the clothings. Okay, and also do not avoid the smoldering of the disposed cigarette, improper disposal. That should be avoided. Okay, and not for the first person, also for the another person as well. So anyone else is smoking and he has properly disposed all the smoking material, the cigarette butts there, they're not smoldering. Always keep an eye on that. Okay, so that will be sufficient regarding